boys and girls to Earth Science Rocks. Today we're gonna take you down to the river.
Was that Goldilocks?
Weird. Today we want to talk to you about erosion and deposition in streams.
Streams and rivers form from runoff that collects in a valley and flows downhill powered by...
Nuclear fusion.
No.
Electric motors.
No.
Whoa.
Gravity.
Force of gravity, that water's cold.
Down there is the Hudson River. And all around me is the Hudson River watershed. And a watershed is an area of land that feeds a body of water. Any precipitation that lands in this watershed will end up in the Hudson River. Because I'm in the Hudson River watershed, the water I'm about to pour will flow right into the Hudson River. There it goes.
Whatever.
Rivers and streams are agents of erosion, which means they carry away sediments.
And because rivers and streams have moving water, they separate the sediments based on particle size.
This happens because faster moving water carries bigger particles. Let us show you.
Here are four different particle sizes. We put them in a mixed pile and spray them with a garden hose. You see, as the velocity increases, bigger particles are carried away.
Here you can see that the river is moving so fast that only boulders are left behind. Here, the water is moving slowly enough that small particles like sand can be left behind. The relationship between water velocity and particle size is demonstrated in your Earth Science reference tables. Be sure you know how to use it.
And three factors affect stream velocity. They are slope, channel shape, and discharge.
Discharge is the amount of water flowing through a stream. Just like a garden hose. The more water in the hose, the faster it flows. So when a stream floods, the water flows faster and erodes more. That's why flooded streams are muddy.
Slope, or gradient, is how steep a stream is. The steeper the stream, the faster the flow. Let's show you.
Here we are at Shelving Rock Falls. As you can see, the slope is very steep. Scientists use oranges to measure how fast a stream flows. They drop the orange in the stream and time it as it goes a certain distance. They plug those numbers into a formula. The same formula that's on the front page of your ESRT. Rate equals change in field value over change in time. Let's figure it out. We'll have Ryan drop an orange from the top of the waterfall. Ready? Go ahead.
That took 4 seconds, and we measured the distance to be 40 feet. If you plug that into the formula, you would get 40 feet divided by 4 seconds, or 10 feet per second.
That's fast moving water. You can see that all that's left behind here is big boulders. Everything else has been washed away by the stream. Let's go find a place where the water's moving a little bit slower.
Here we are at the same stream. Got about the same amount of water moving by, and we're gonna try to figure out how fast the water's flowing here. Obviously, the slope is a lot less. We got a 20-foot measure set up, and we're gonna drop an orange in at the end and time how long it takes to travel down it. So we saw this orange moving down along the tape, 20 feet, and it took about 10 seconds. So if we work that into the formula, it works out to be about 2 feet per second. Definitely nowhere near as fast as the last thing we just saw. Because of this water, a lot of the smaller pieces are being moved away, but still we got medium particles that are left behind. We've got some boulders, some cobble, and a couple pebbles. So let's go check out a place that's moving even slower than this, one that has even a slighter slope.
Here we are where the stream is almost level. Go ahead, Jason. The orange moved 5 feet in 15 seconds. That is 0.33 feet or 4 inches per second. Wow, that's really slow. As you can see, most of the bottom of the stream is sand.
So much math.
I know. Oh, hey, look, there's a meander.
Here we are in an old flat valley. There's a stream running through it. As you can see, the stream is flat and is moving slowly. Streams in old valleys like this tend to meander, which means they curve. Now, when streams go around a meander, they go faster on the outside and slower on the inside. As a result, you get deposition on the inside, making sandbars like the one here. And on the outside, the water will be deeper because of all the erosion from the fast-moving water. Let me show you. Here I go, from the inside of the meander to the outside of the meander. Watch the water depth as I walk towards the outside of the meander. It's getting pretty deep, as you can see. Woo! Whoa! Very deep on the outside of the meander. You also wind up with undercut banks from all the erosion. Ah. Here on the outside of the meander, where the water's been moving fast, all the small particles have been worn away. All that's left is the big ones on the bottom. Let me show you. Woo! All we have here is gravel. Everything smaller than gravel has been washed away. Here we are at the inside of the meander where the water's moving slow and particles like sand are deposited.
In this meander, we'll drop a ribbon in the stream and watch it flow in the current. You see the water moves faster on the outside of the meander.
Water velocity and channel shape are different where a stream is straight.
Here we place a ribbon in a straight section of stream. You can see the current moves fastest in the middle.
Here, you'll see it's deepest in the middle. Pretty deep. Pretty shallow. We've shown you that water can sort particles as the slope changes and in meanders. But water can also sort particles in deltas.
Here we are at English Brook Delta in Lake George. This delta is formed where English Brook flows into the lake and the water velocity slows down, depositing sediments. This delta is amazing. The sandbar I'm standing on wasn't here a year ago, and it won't be here a year from now. It's constantly changing as a result of wave erosion and stream erosion. In the 1970s, the shoreline was all the way back by that house back there.
Here I am where the brook first enters into the lake. The brook is an erosional depositional system. All of the deposition is from erosion that happened way upstream. Most erosion and deposition occurs during floods. Last flood, the water was probably well over my head. The only particles I could drop were these large cobbles that you see here. All the smaller pieces were washed into the lake. So here, further downstream and closer to the lake, the water moves slower, and the particles that we'll find are going to be much smaller, like these smaller pieces here. Out here, further in the delta, where the water is going very slow, the particle sizes are even smaller. Clearly, you can see that the particles are getting smaller as the water velocity gets slower.
Let's review what we've learned. Streams are agents of erosion powered by gravity.
A watershed is the area of land that feeds a body of water.
Water can sort sediments when it changes velocity. The slower the water, the smaller the particles deposited.
Three factors affect water velocity: stream discharge, slope, and meanders.
As stream discharge increases, water velocity increases.
As slope increases, water velocity increases.
Water moves faster along the outside of a meander, creating a deeper channel.
In a straight stream, water moves fastest in the middle.
Erosion and deposition occur in equilibrium with each other.
When a stream flows into a lake, a delta is formed and bigger particles are deposited first.
Well, that's it for this time.
Until the next Earth Science Rocks, have a nice day!